tonight I'm going to share with you an ultra portable, insanely easy to use deep sky astrophotography setup that I've recently put together. This is not like any other kit I've shared on this channel before, mainly because I don't usually use plate solving or mobile apps to control my astrophotography sessions. The kids call me old school, or just old. But not anymore. Welcome to 2007, Trevor Jones, and the wild, time-saving world of plate solving. Why didn't anyone tell me? Okay, obviously I knew about plate solving, but I didn't use it very often, especially on mobile-friendly setups and star trackers. My observatory, of course, when it was still here, used plate solving to find and solve faint deep sky objects in the night sky. But it was a robust, permanent setup that took a long time to get sorted out. And that was the biggest reason I avoided it for so long. I am perpetually swapping scopes, cameras, mounts, heck, even imaging laptops throughout the year. And getting the software sorted out each time I made a change wasted precious clear sky time. So I would usually just star align the mounts myself using the hand controller and I was on my way. Enter the ASI Air. The software on this incredible little red box is so easy to use, even a monkey could get set up and get a deep sky image on their first or second night out with it. Okay, maybe not a monkey, but a surprisingly average technological fellow in his late 30s with a receding hairline and great teeth. Okay, before I get right into exactly how it works, here's a complete breakdown of the entire kit that I'm using. The Skywatcher Star Adventurer GTI Star Tracker mount, the Radian Carbon Fiber Quick Release Tripod, the Radian 61 Triplet Apel Refractor Telescope, a ZWO ASI 2400 MC Pro Color Camera, the Starfield Optics 50mm Guide Scope, a ZWO ASI 120mm Pro guide camera, an aging Samsung tablet just for a bigger screen than my phone, and most importantly, the ZWO ASI Air Plus. I also use a pretty weathered 12 volt 4 amp power adapter to power the ASI Air mini PC. I'm also plugged into household power this time to plug in my dew heater bands, but all of this could be replaced with a portable battery pack, which I'll cover in a future video. Oh yeah, and one more very important item, this cable. This cable connects the ASI Air to the mount and opens up its most powerful feature. Speaking of cables, there is one that is noticeably missing on this setup, one that I couldn't live without for the last 10 years. The ST4, that's right, no more guiding like a goon using an ancient phone jack. We're straight up pulse guiding to the mount now, no more on camera like a caveman. Serious though, if you're still using an ST4 cable and killing it, let the good times roll. Don't let them change you. Essentially, the ASI Air guiding system sends pulses directly to the mount to make corrections in the tracking, as opposed to through the guide camera like I used to. Now, this is an improvement already. Not a huge one, but one that I'm happy to have. But the real power of this RJ45 control cable for Skywatcher mounts is the new plate solving abilities the mount now has. Yes, the Star Adventurer GTI can already go to objects in the night sky on its own, but the ASI Air and this cable takes it to the next level. This system makes the object location and framing stages of the astrophotography process dead simple. You just search for the deep sky object you want in the database on the ASI Air and the mount will automatically slew to it and center it for you. Yeah, it's that easy. Your telescope mount now knows exactly where it's pointed without you fumbling back and forth confirming alignment stars. Even if a good old three-star alignment routine makes me feel nostalgic and more connected to the night sky. Saving 20 minutes of imaging time feels pretty darn good. Here's how it works. Here's a look at the ASI Air user interface. You can do everything here from polar alignment to setting camera temperature to focusing. Now, I've used an ASI Air for several years to run an imaging plan and autoguide, but I didn't tap into the incredibly easy telescope control features until now. Here's the telescope connection panel where I can confirm that I do indeed have my telescope connected. The mount selection is Skywatcher AZ GTI/SynScan Wi-Fi. That is connected to the Star Adventurer GTI using the cable I spoke about earlier. And then now I can open up the planetarium mode
and select my first object. Since I'd like to dial in my focus before shooting my deep sky target for tonight, I'll pick a bright star. So I know that Vega's in a great spot right now and it's nice and bright. That's a good one for manually focusing using a Batinoff mask. I don't have an autofocuser on this setup yet. Here's Vega here and I just tap it and then go to. You should see the telescope in the background moving there. It is now slewing to Vega. Now remember, I haven't done any type of star alignment at this point. The mount is going to find this star and center its position on its own by taking some pictures and plate solving the star fields it sees. It will automatically center the star. And you might be thinking, you know, a bright star is easy to find. I could have done that on my own. But what about an extremely faint dark nebula that's nearly impossible to locate manually? The software will find, confirm, and center any object you want to photograph. It's pretty incredible. I'm seeing some little notifications here, and now that star is centered. So if I go back into photo mode, I could take a photo of that star. So why don't we take a 5-second exposure just to confirm that Vega is in the center of the field. Exposing. And what do you know? We have Vega right in the dead center of the field. So whether it's a star or it's a deep sky object, you can just literally tap the location of it on the planetarium and the mount will automatically slew to it. It's just magic. My camera and telescope are currently collecting light on the Veil Nebula Complex, a dramatic intersection of supernova remnants in the night sky. The massive field of view on the Radian 61 means that I can capture the remains of this exploded star in its entirety. I went with the Optolong L Extreme filter for this target, and when you see my final image, I think you'll completely understand why. Even though I can see it visually in each sub-exposure, the field of view indicator with the exact orientation on the ASIAIR star map confirms that I have indeed enveloped the entire region. So yeah, I used to manually star align my telescope mounts in place of a software-aided plate solving routine. Like I said before, this was just a matter of convenience and routine with maybe a dash of procrastination. However, I was shocked at how well the ASIAIR mount control of this little star tracker performed. It was one of the most painless new astro gear moments I've ever experienced. To have a grab and go setup like this with such control, such precision, is really exciting to me. The reason I created this video was so not only that you knew this option exists, but that it's probably a lot better than you think. If you're extremely tech savvy, chances are you will probably build or already have a system that can do all of this using a mix of components and solutions. As you know, there's a million ways to go about the astrophotography experience, and the road you take will likely come down to preference and budget. I look forward to expanding this system even further, including an electronic focuser and filter wheel, and of course I'll bring you along for the ride. So this is my travel astro rig for the summer of 2022, and I can't wait to get it under some dark skies. I hope you enjoy my final image of the Veil Nebula taken with this setup, and until next time, clear skies.